Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Wooden Railway Adventures, Episode 247, Wellsworth the Wait. A few days later, it was time for Dustin and the Admiral to explore the abandoned track near Wellsworth Station. Glad you're feeling better, Dustin. Here's the line I was talking about earlier. It seems so inconspicuous, and yet it beckons to be explored. We must take a closer look. Do you think Sailor John might be hiding out there? Potentially, but even if he's not, think of all the discoveries that could lie beyond this sign. I couldn't call myself an explorer if I didn't venture within. Just then, Gordon puffed up. Of course, another red signal. Just my luck. This train will reach Vickerstown, probably by the end of the week, if I'm lucky. You can't go anywhere on this island anymore. Dustin and the Admiral looked innocently at the big engine. What? Are you two the reason I'm being stopped here? What's going on? Sorry, Gordon, but we have to take a look at this abandoned siding. I was going to let Dustin do the honors and chop the sign to bits, but Sir Topham Hatt prefers a more dignified disassembly. The pack is on the way right now, he added. We'll be out of your way soon. Gordon let off steam loudly. I guess I better get comfortable if it's going to be a while. The express being upstaged by a snow shovel and a man with a funny hat. I've seen it all now. A few minutes later, Kelly, Jack, and Alfie arrived and quickly dismantled the sign. Sir Topham Hatt will be along shortly to see what you found, they said. Then we must get cracking. Onwards, Dustin. Let's cut through these brambles and see what lies on the other side. Just then, a Crosby Station cargo truck roared in and honked loudly. Its engine revved over and over. What's his problem? Does he want a race? No, that's Sailor John, exclaimed the Admiral. He's driving the same truck I saw up at the quarry. Never mind all this. After him, Dustin! And the truck raced away with Dustin right behind it. Gordon took a deep breath and sighed. Well, at least they're gone now. Maybe I can finally get my express moving. But the signal was still red. Gordon wouldn't be going anywhere anytime soon. Well, this is awkward, muttered Alfie. We just took the sign down, and now the Admiral and Dustin aren't here to explore. Maybe one of us could see what's over there, asked Kelly.
No, it must be me, insisted Gordon.
Why you? Protested Jack.
Because I am the most senior member of Sir Topham Hatt's railway in attendance, and it would be a pity if one of you messed up something on the other side. I'll take full responsibility for what I find.
Jack stared crossly as Gordon was uncoupled from his train. Sure, go ahead and leave your waiting passengers at the platform.
This will only take a minute, he grumbled. There can't possibly be anything terribly surprising over there.
Gordon inched slowly down the track and worked his way up a small hill, where he puffed into a mysterious cave.
Never mind what I said. This is very interesting. I wonder why the line was blocked off in the first place.
Just then, Gordon stopped. He peered over the edge of the track and saw three familiar, horrid lorries parked below.
Cinders and ashes! Those pesky lorries! Why, I should go down there and deal with them myself!
When do you think Sailor John will be back? Asked Lorry One.
Probably not for a while. He mentioned that the engines were snooping around the entrance to the mine earlier, and that he might run out and do a diversion or something.
That's precisely what he did, whispered Gordon. Just as Dustin was about to head down the line, the cargo truck appeared and drew him away. I guess he didn't think about a big blue engine like myself taking a look instead.
Listen, guys, now that Sailor John's not here, I'm not so sure about this renewed partnership we have with him. Ugh, not this again. We've been over this. Sailor John is our best bet in order to get these steam engines off the rails and into the scrapyard so that we can take over the island. Yes, but remember how he treated us? He left us to clean up his mess last time. He was going to abandon us and take the treasure away. Surely he'll do the same thing this time. Remember, it's not about the treasure. It's about revenge. We lorries have sat silent for too long. We do the dirty work, and the engines get the praise and recognition. I don't care if Sailor John finds any treasure or not. He wants to take down the railway, and that is a plan all of us can get behind. Lorry, too, was still uncertain. Again, I don't have a good feeling about this. Gordon was shocked. Not only are the horrid lorries back on Sodor, but they're also scheming with Sailor John again. This is worse than I could have imagined. I must go tell Sir Topham Hatt right away. Gordon tried to reverse, but he bumped into something behind him. What is that? He wondered.
Caught peeking at me lorries, have ya? You won't be getting out of this one, Gordon. Let me show you what I'm gonna do to all of the engines on the Sodor Railway.
Meanwhile, Jack and his friends were still waiting outside the mine when Sir Topham had arrived. Are Dustin and the Admiral inside already? What's happening? Have we heard anything about their progress?
Well, no, not really. You see, the Admiral and Dustin went chasing after one of those Crosby Station cargo trucks, and so there was nobody left to go inside, which meant Gordon, of course, had to volunteer himself.
Wait, Gordon went down the track? What is he thinking? He has an express to pull right now.
We tried to tell him, sir, but he wouldn't listen.
Bother, this is no time to be sightseeing, Gordon. Come out at once. Look, the signal is green and your passengers are waiting.
But there was no reply. Sir Topham Hatt was growing impatient.
Fine, I'll venture inside myself. It can't be that scary.
Just then, Dustin and the Admiral raced in.
Where's Sailor John? Asked Alfie.
Ah, we lost him, grumbled Dustin. He kept veering away from the track and I couldn't keep up. I think you'll need an off-road vehicle for your next chase, Admiral.
We'll see about that later. Ah, Sir Topham Hatt, so nice of you to join us. We're about to be the first crew to explore the line in as many years.
Just then, the Admiral noticed the express coaches.
We're not going to be the first crew to explore the line in as many years, are we?
No, and Gordon's not obeying my command to come out here at once. Dear me, these engines nowadays.
Let us take a look, sir. We don't know what we're going to find on the other side, but Dustin and I are equipped to handle any surprises.
Very well, but please make it quick. We must get this express moving so that the passengers aren't waiting here at Wellsworth any longer.
Just then, Sir Topham Hatt and the Admiral heard a loud whooshing noise, followed by...
Oh, get off of me, you dirty pirate! You won't be sending me to the scrapyard!
Gordon, easy now, Gordon! What happened? What did you see?
Oh, you wouldn't believe it, sir. The lorries, they were... And then Sailor John, big truck, couldn't move. But I showed him I got away before he was able to lay a finger on me.
Whoa, you said you saw Sailor John inside? Did you speak to him?
He threatened me, is what he did. I heard the lorries talking about a plan, and then he showed up out of nowhere and said he was going to make an example of me. Oh, it was terrible, sir.
"We must close off this line and keep Sailor John where he is," said the Admiral. "This is our chance to end this once and for all."
Excuse me, said the passengers. "We're wondering if someone is going to pull our train today. We're very, 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 very..."
"Oh, of course. Never mind the fact that I was nearly cut up a few minutes ago. Let me pull your train so that you can get on your merry way."
And with that, Gordon rushed out of the station, with the passengers barely making it aboard in time.
"What a rush!" gasped Kelly.
"What a mess!" muttered Sir Topham Hatt.
"We must end this at once."
Dustin and the Admiral raced into the mine and quickly discovered the horrid lorries. Sailor John, however, was nowhere to be found.
"The lorries aren't going anywhere. They're out of fuel, it seems. But Sailor John has somehow escaped. I don't know how he did it, but he's not in there. Can't find his truck, either."
"Well, let's be thankful no one got hurt and call this a win for today. Jack, get your crew to haul those lorries out of there right now. I need to talk to them immediately. Dustin, I want you to guard this line and make sure nobody passes you. And Admiral, I think it's time we got you a new vehicle. Dustin has served you well, but if Sailor John insists on taking this battle to the roads, then we must do the same. This small victory has been well worth the wait. Well done, everybody. Let's savor it while we can, while preparing for more action tomorrow."